Hi guys, welcome to another episode of Momina's Mixplain. Today I have Amna Ilyas in the studio with me and we're going to be talking about Saat Din Mohabbat in the new movie that is coming out on Eid. And we're going to be playing Two Truths, One Lie and getting to know Amna a little better. I've known her for a very long time because she's been modeling and, you know, she's been in my life for a while and I can't wait to introduce her and like talk to her the way I talk to her always. Hi Amna.
Hi Momna, thank you so much for having me on your show.
Of course, yeah. Thanks for coming.
No, thank you for having me, honestly.
So excited for Saat Din Mohabbat Din?
Super excited. I think excited is a very small word for it. Initially, I was a little skeptical, you would say. I was a little reluctant. Because obviously working with such a big cast like Myra, Sheryar, and of course I worked
with daunting.
Yes, it is. And working with Meenu and Farjad for the second time was obviously a pleasure. Right now, because now we're traveling throughout Pakistan and doing the promotions and everything, so it's kind of gotten synced in now.
You know, this is happening, and you know,
absolutely,
this is what we're doing, and it's gonna be fun, and you know,
I think I'm just easy over here, so I'm happy about that.
Yeah, I think it takes a little
time. And also, I think the response is amazing so far that we're getting.
Yeah,
just like we've been doing a lot of mall activities and interacting with.
I've heard. At the podium.
Yeah.
That was insane.
That was.
And I heard like one of the publicists was thrown into like a makeup kiosk.
It was not just that the poor publicist, but I would say it was me, Mahira, Sheryar, my makeup artist Ashad. He was really badly hurt.
Yeah. Okay, so let's talk a little bit about 7MDL. You know, So what's your favorite dialogue from Saat Din Mohabbat Din?
My favorite dialogue, my own dialogue, which I really like, which was kind of a tongue twister. When I first read it, I told Farjad, I can't do this. This is ये कैसे याद होगा मुझे? जिसका अब भी मुझे honestly speaking आधा याद है, मुझे पूरा dialogue नहीं याद.
अच्छा.
नसीबा बाजी, आपने मुझे जिस जंग के लिए तैयार किया था, उसकी शुरुआत अब. एक बदकार, बदकमाश, बदबख्त मर्द की बर्बादी का भयानक अंजाम गजाला के हाथों लिखा.
हाँ, so this dialogue of yours is a
yeah, and this is half of it by the way. So this was a tongue twister kind of a thing. That जो मैंने दो takes में कर दिया था, so I was kind of proud of myself.
I मुझसे तो होएगा, मुझे अभी बताओ मैं ना बोल सकूँ, अभी चार दिन बाद भी कहना तो मैं नहीं बोल सकूँगी ये. अच्छा anyway, so if there was one outfit or one look from 7DMI, then मैं Nokia का जो मेरा बड़ा fit phone है, मेरा नया आ रहा है phone, इसके अंदर like if you had to wear a look from there on the premiere, which one would it be?
I think it would be from the climax scene that we did. I wore a very nice dull gold outfit. It was harem pants with a long shirt.
Oh, that's
a short shirt.
Who was the easiest actor to work with on set?
The easiest actor, I would say Sheryar.
Yeah.
There was just one scene I did with Myra. Mm-hmm. But I think hanging out with her on the set was great.
Yeah, I'm sure. She's so funny.
Yeah, she's so she's fun. She's funny, you know. She's easier to talk to. And but overall, I think I had most of my scenes with Sheryar. So definitely, Sheryar is very, very easy to work with.
Okay. How do you think your modeling career has helped your acting career?
Normally, there's this conception about models that they can't act. Okay.
Yeah, that's but it's interesting because if you see Bollywood, 90% of the top models were actually like
actors
are now were actually models first.
Yeah.
You know? Like and all their fame came from you know kind of like.
But I think it gets a little tougher on you because you have to prove yourself as an actor. So having that modeling background, kind of. You know, people just have this thing in their minds that, you know, this person cannot act because this person's job is to do, just
look
to look
sexy,
look good, look glamorous and that's all. It was
kind of, I think it didn't like push you to kind of do better than what you were like would have imagined if you were just an actor. Like now that you have to prove yourself, you kind of push yourself more.
I take roles, I take characters that I think that I can pull off in.
Okay.
Okay, so I kind of play safe.
Yeah.
I wouldn't jump into something that I would think that, you know, I can't. Deliver.
Yeah.
So the thing is that so that's about it. And I think of course it gives me a push because I do want to prove myself as an actor, and I have in my previous films.
Yes, you have.
People think that I'm a better actor. Of course, a great model, but also a better actor.
One memory that you will cherish from the sets of 7DMI.
So there was a scene, we shot it, and it was really funny because me and Hina Dilpazir, we were on the roof of the van. And so that, I think it was really funny. Overall, that experience was really, really, really funny.
Okay. So who's your favorite romantic comedy character ever?
It would be Kareena Kapoor from Jab We Met.
Yeah.
She was cute, fun.
She was relatable. Yeah.
And you know, the thing is that I think that film is kind of timeless. Whenever you watch that movie,
you relate to it.
You relate to it.
Yeah. You relate to it. Social media now plays such a massive role in pretty much everything that is happening. And social media trolls are some of my least favorite people.
I also really like
to go through what the hell they're saying. So what's your weirdest comment that you've received on social media?
Well, it was recently. I was in Maldives for a camping. I was shooting over there. And the minute I landed, so you know, we started posting pictures and you know, you do all of that stuff. So I posted a picture and there was a comment under it. And the comment was, it was hilarious, by the way. The comment was, "Pahunch gayi londe bazi karne Maldives." I was like, what?
Okay, what's the worst purchase you've ever made?
I'm not really happy about that. I bought an Hermes belt. I don't know why I bought that.
Please,
I mean,
guys,
I wore it twice. I think in the past 1.5 years, I wore it twice.
So basically, you want to be a lowry ladka.
And
I made a badi si age belt laga ke nikluga, log samjhega, I'm the shit.
And it's just there. I don't know why I bought it. I don't even wear it.
I'm judging you a little.
Do that.
I'm judging you. What's the worst? What's the one thing that people think about you that's not true?
I think a lot of my people that I think because of the look that I have or the kind of personality that I have, that a lot of people think that I'm a bit arrogant, but I think I'm not.
No, I don't.
And once you get to know me, then you know.
No, you're not. I don't think you're arrogant.
Yeah.
I think sometimes you just have to be a little standoffish just because of the.
Yeah, because also I think I don't take any sort of bullshit from people.
Yeah. I have a really fun game we're gonna play.
Okay.
So we're going to play this game called Two Truths, One Lie.
Yeah.
And I personally love it. So I'm going to give out three statements.
Mm.
Two of them are true. One of them is false. You have to pick out my false and I'm going to pick up your false. Okay. So since obviously I'm the star of the show and you're just, you know, so I'll go first. I've lived in the Philippines. I once missed a flight because I was buying Burger King. My parents took me on a road trip to Quetta.
I think the first one, that you've lived in Philippines.
I've lived in the Philippines. That's a lie.
You have?
Yes. We used to have a house there.
Okay. So which one was a lie?
Road trip to Quetta. Let's hear yours now. Your turn.
So the first one is that I own 2 lambs as pet. I have more than 50 pair of heels. My left bedside drawer is full of chocolates.
You own more than 50 pairs of heels.
That's a lie.
Actually, that can't be a lie since you're a model. Like, that's the most obvious thing that you would think would be a lie, right? Like, I want you to have a pet lamb. I would want to believe that I live in a world where you have 2 lambs as a pet.
But you think that's a lie?
I'm going to go with chocolates in your drawer.
That's a lie?
Yeah.
No, that's not a lie.
What's a lie?
The lie is that I have more than 50 pair of heels.
I was right in the first one!
So I was kind of bluffing you. I think I'm done with your stupid statements. So I think now I'm going to ask you a few questions.
Achha, main hot seat.
Haan, ab aap hot seat pe hain. Aur aapka pehla sawal. Why did you come up with the show?
The idea behind it was to kind of, I know a lot of you guys, like I've worked with you in fashion and like just generally in the industry. So it was like more of a thing of kind of presenting content in a different manner. Like I feel like there was so much saturation in magazines, etc.
You mean to say that other talk shows are really boring and yours is like a little...
No, it was just like the YouTube as a medium was not being used for... Haan, we're supposed to be baat sahi
hai. Aise hote hai na, host aise hote hai na. Nahi, toh ab kya kehna kya chah rahi hai?
Kya chah rahi hai? Haan, bataye ab aap.
Do you believe in karma?
Yes, I do.
You're such a loser.
I believe in karma and I've actually experienced and I'm hoping that it happens to other people also. There are certain people on my radar and I'm like, ye toh hona jeet.
Achha. Who's your favorite writer? Because I know you used to study journalism and everything. Who's your favorite writer?
As cliched as it sounds, I love J.K. Rowling. I love the Harry Potter series. I love Lord of the Rings. So I think I like fantasy.
You're into fantasy?
Yeah, reading. So I know that you rap. Okay, guys, so Amna raps.
Well, I only do it in my toilet, so.
So, okay, well, then you're gonna rap for me.
Is this the toilet? Okay, so I'm gonna do this little piece from Eminem.
Okay.
I'm sure you must have heard the song Love the Way You Lie.
Of course.
Yeah, one of my favorite songs.
Love the way you lie.
Now I know we said things, did things, things we didn't mean, and we fall back into the same pattern, same routine, but your temper just as bad as mine is. You same as me when it comes to love, you're just as blinded. Baby, please come back. It wasn't you. Baby, it was me. Maybe our relationship isn't me crazy as it seems. Maybe that's what happened when a tornado meets a volcano. All I know is I love you too much to walk away though. Come inside, pick up the bags at the sidewalk. Don't you hear sincerity in my voice when I talk? Told you this is my fault. Look me in the eye, boy. Next time I pissed, I my fist at the drywall. Next time, there would be no next time. I apologize, even though I know it's lies. I'm tired of the games, I just want her back. I know I'm a liar if she ever tries to fucking leave again. I'm a tired to the bed and set this house on fire.
Well freaking done!
Really?
I think you should do a thing with Abid Rohi. I think Simply Boy, really? And you should like do.
Okay, no, I think I'm terrible. It's just that I do this when I'm really stressed out. So what I do is I put a rap song on YouTube and I just kind of go with it.
Well, thank you so much for coming in. Thank you so much for being a part of this. And guys, please go out and watch Saat Din Mohabbat In this Eid. And I'll be there and I'm super excited for this film. And Amna will also be there. And
yes.
Everyone else will be there.
Please, please, please come and watch Saat Din Mohabbat In. We're really looking forward to you guys. Dekhi aur please give us your feedback.
And if you liked the interview, please subscribe, comment, share, and let me know in the comments below what was your favorite part of the interview and what you would like to see more of. Until next time then.